This is Command Post, a series of discussions about military matters from Time and the Center for a New American Security.
John, you're sort of an architect of a counterinsurgency strategy in this country. You helped General Petraeus write the manual on it. Some folks are saying that the troop drawdown effectively means we'll be abandoning counterinsurgency for more of a CT, a counterterrorism, go off the bad guys, go after the bad guys kind of thing. Is that how you see it? Is it black and white?
I don't think it's nearly that clear. And so my first response is we may no longer be interested in counterinsurgency, but counterinsurgency is still interested in us. So after Vietnam, we as a nation turned away from that capability and then discovered that we needed it really, really badly during the worst years of the war in Iraq. But the counterinsurgency strategy in Afghanistan, I think, is clearly going to continue, at least in the South and the Southwest, where American forces supported by Afghan forces are going to continue to do the clearing, the holding, the building. The big question, I think, is whether General John Allen of the United States Marine Corps, if he's confirmed, is going to have the resources necessary to conduct counterinsurgency in the East, or if he's going to have to move to counterterrorism there. And I think we don't know the answers to that yet. He's going to have to be really creative in what the military calls battlefield calculus, figuring out which troops you place where to see if he's going to have the resources to pursue counterinsurgency or if he's going to be restricted to just counterterrorism in the regional command east. The other important point to make, I think, is that while American forces are increasingly not going to be conducting counterinsurgency over time, inevitably we were going to leave behind an advise and assist presence and a counterterrorism presence in Afghanistan. That's always the idea in a counterinsurgency campaign. You want the host nation forces, the Afghan security forces, to take over the counterinsurgency role for you. And I think one of the big questions that we have from the president's announcement is, are the Afghan forces ready to pick up the responsibility to do counterinsurgency on their own? Do we have enough American units configured, trained, organized, equipped to assist them in that mission?
Yeah, Ambassador Zalmay Khalilzad just wrote a piece on this critiquing the president's speech. One of the interesting markers he put in that, he was both ambassador in Afghanistan during my 19 months there, but then went on to be the ambassador in Iraq immediately thereafter. He noted that when the surge occurred in Iraq, there were nearly 1 million Iraqi security forces available to put into that fight. In Afghanistan today, that number is just short of 300,000. And Afghanistan is about 1.5 times the size of Iraq, with a population about the same that's dispersed all across the country. So John's point's exactly right. You know, one of the unknowns right now, but one of the key factors I think the president is relying on for the success of his outline policy is having adequate Afghan forces that are trained, equipped, and have the will to fight to get in and replace some of these American units that are coming out.
To the extent that U.S. forces continue to be involved in the counterinsurgency campaign there is a political risk that comes up, because a lot of the clearing operations of getting the Taliban out of the places where they've been entrenched and pushing into new areas such as the East will inevitably involve casualties. When you bring the fight to the enemy, there are more casualties that occur just as part of warfare. The tone of the president's speech was very much a lot of success has been achieved, and so we're going to draw down in a measured way just to make sure we don't squander any of those gains. But to the extent that General Allen chooses a more aggressive counterinsurgency strategy with the troops that he's got available to him, there may be a disconnect with the American public as casualties will go up during the summer fighting season.